Hey everyone, it's Karthik and welcome back to CodeBlock. Guys, in the previous video of Python end-to-end course tutorial, we have just discussed about how to create a small library system using Python, and in this video we are going to discuss about kinter widgets and their attributes. So before getting late, let's get started. And guys, before starting the video, make sure that you have liked this video, subscribe to Codelem Docs channel, and don't forget to follow us on Instagram, and don't forget to visit on codelem1.pythonanywhere.com. So anyways, let's start. Guys, basically the graphical user interface, which is GUI, is used by the most commercially popular computer operating system and software programs today. It's the kind of interface that allows users to manipulate elements on the screen using a mouse or a stylus or even a finger. So now guys, we discuss about the widgets. So guys, widgets are the basic building blocks of graphical user interface GUI applications. Each GUI component, it be like a button or a label, is a widget that is placed somewhere within a user interface window or is displayed as an independent window. So guys, there are some methods, so let's discuss about these methods one by one. So the first method is pack method. And guys, this method organizes the widgets in a block before placing in the parent widget. So guys, basically this packs the widget to the parent widget. And this second one is grid widget. So guys, it organizes the widget in the grid table-like structure before placing in the parent widget. And now guys, the place widget. So guys, this basically places the widgets on a specific position directed by a programmer. Guys, in Python, almost each widget object has several attributes. Here we'll talk about standard widget. Attribute includes you can say it as a cursor and colors and forms. So guys, kinter widget state. The state of the kinter widget is defined by state attributes, which is normal, active and disabled. And the values of the attributes are, so the first kinter widget padding. Now guys, pad x and pad y, these two attributes came under this which respectively add extra horizontal and vertical spaces to the widget, and the pad x and pad y attribute add space between the buttons. And guys, now kinter background colors. So guys, the background colors of widget can be set with the background attribute, and that attribute name is bg. And guys, now width height, width and height. Guys, the width and height attribute sets the width and height of the widget. And now guys, kinter fonts. For working with fonts, it has a font module. It has some built-in such fonts as TK, which is kinter tooltip font, and the default font. And now guys, kinter cursor. Guys, the cursor in the kinter is set with the cursor and kinter refills. Guys, a refill is a border decoration. The possible values are sunken and raised and groove and flat. So guys, I hope you understand this kinter widget and their attributes. So guys, in the next tutorial we will learn something more about Python. For that, bye bye, see you later and take care.